You will get the most from any Systems to Win video when you launch it from its video homepage.
Like all training, you're going to get a whole lot more out of this if you actually do it rather than just watching. So if you don't yet own your license and you haven't yet downloaded your free trial, pause this video and download it now. When the add-in is successfully installed, you'll see the Systems to Win tab in Excel. In the Systems to Win menu, select the Systems to Win Templates button, where you'll find all 150 plus of your Systems to Win templates in alphabetical order. Scroll down and select the Work Instructions template, or Trial-Work Instructions in the trial version. And then your template opens to the Help worksheet. If you already completed your Quick Start Initial Training, then you already know this, along with many other features that are common to all 150 plus of your Systems to Win templates. And you know that the next thing to do is to go back to your Systems to Win tab and click the button to open a blank sheet. Now here's where things get different. Rather than just opening a blank sheet where you do your work, you're presented with a choice. Do you want your new sheet to include the advanced features for a product or service family? Or do you want your new sheet to be stripped of those features because you are only doing work instructions for a simple standalone process? Now, before we get into the how, let's talk just a moment about why. What are the benefits of product families? And those benefits are enormous. Less data entry, clearer instructions, and fewer mistakes. Those are huge, huge benefits. So let's go take a look deeper now. So when faced with this question, let's first say yes, we are working with a product or service family that has products or services that have a lot of similar steps, but some things are different. So the first thing that you'll see is this dialog that says, see the online training. Don't just click the OK button and say, yeah, yeah, yeah. You'll get a whole lot more value from your tool if you actually click this link and take sufficient time to honestly learn how to use not only these advanced features for product families, but a whole lot of other surprising features that make it a lot easier to create very professional work instructions. So let's look deeper into that first of the benefits of a product family. When we say far less data entry, what do we mean? That means that you're going to do all of your data entry for the entire product or service family on one sheet. For example, let's right-click this sheet tab and rename it. You'll usually name it something representative of the product or service family. We'll just call ours Family Master. And when we scroll down to this section where we do data entry, we will use this Show column to specify which steps should be shown or hidden for the different products or services in your family. Because the template starts out blank, let's look at the sample data. And again, let's scroll down to the section where we do the data entry. And notice that if that show column is blank for that row, then that step is performed for every product or service within the family. So let's scroll down to that place in our sample data where we demonstrate examples of how to use your show rows codes. And we notice that for step 21 is performed only by part ABC, whereas step number 22 is not performed by part ABC. Step 22 is performed only for those ID codes Your and Brief. And step 23, because it begins with exclamation point not, that means that that step is performed for all products or items in that family except for the one that has the ID code YOUR. And if we go to the DV tab, we see the ID table where you define your ID codes for your product or service family. Now, if you happen to have part numbers and they are short, then the ID code might be your part number, but they can be anything, perhaps for a service family. And notice that the top row is the default data for the entire product family. And then for each of the optional ID codes below, they can either have their own data, or if any field is blank for that item, then it defaults to the data for the top row, the product family. In this way, you can optionally maintain separate version control for every part in the product family. So then back on your real family master sheet, or in our case, we're going to use the sample. When we click this button to generate report, and we click OK to this safety dialog, then if we select this radio button for all codes, and then click the OK button, then it will take a while because it's doing an awful lot behind the curtain, but in a minute or two, it will generate separate worksheets for both your overall master product family, in this case sample, and separate worksheets for each of the items in your product or service family. And the header data at the top of each sheet has the correct header information and version control information for each of the items in your family. And when we scroll down to the section that contains the work instructions, we see that each sheet correctly includes and excludes those steps that are and are not relevant to that item. And we notice that the steps are correctly numbered. In other words, step 22 for one item might be step 21 or 23 for another, thereby providing much clearer instructions. And both reduced data entry and clearer instructions mean fewer mistakes, fewer quality issues, fewer safety issues, lower costs. When you first opened your blank sheet, you notice that there's something different about this template. It's the only SystemsWin template that is not WYSIWYG. What you see is what you get. In other words, on that data entry sheet, you need to scroll to the right to get to the section where you enter your header data that will appear at the top of each page. Or you scroll down to get to the section where you enter your work instructions. So your master data entry sheet is not WYSIWYG, but each of your generated sheets are. Each generated sheet has the header data at the top and the work instructions below. So back on our master data entry sheet for a product family, notice that some of those header fields have asterisks. And if we click one of those cells, the pop-up help tells us, for product families, you want to edit all asterisk fields on the DV sheet, not here. And if we hover our mouse over the data entry cell, a comment will pop up and remind us of the same thing. We want to do the data entry for those asterisk cells on the DV sheet, where we notice that each of the columns in the ID table correlate with each of the asterisk fields in the header data, including these two optional columns for optional user-defined data. Back on the master data entry sheet, we can optionally right-click unhide that row that contains those two fields that you can optionally use in creative ways for data that varies by item in your product or service families. So now you know most of what you need to know to use those advanced features to really powerfully handle product and service families. But what about when you want to do a simple standalone process? You don't need all those advanced features for product families. How do you strip them away to make your work instructions template easier to use? And you already know the answer to that question. When you click that button to open a blank sheet, and you get that dialog box that asks, do you want the advanced features for a product or service family? This time you're going to answer no. And the first thing to notice is that this time in the header data there are no asterisks. When you hover over a cell, there is no pop-up comment telling you to do data entry on the DV sheet. You enter all of your header data right there on that simple sheet. No fancy extra features to confuse anybody. And the other thing to notice when you scroll down to the section where you enter your work instructions is that you don't see the column to hide or show different items, because we don't want to confuse an entry-level data entry person with features that they might not yet understand. But that column is still there, and you can optionally unhide it to optionally use those hide and show row codes in creative ways. Let's go to the sample tab to give you an example. Let's say that this step 25 is performed only for part ABC. And we remember from our other training video that if we rename this step to start with anything other than the word step, for example, maybe this is an optional or additional instruction just for part ABC, then when we click the button to renumber steps, then notice how step 26 is now going to become step 25. So in other words, if you're not using the advanced features for product families, you can still get kind of close as long as any optional or additional instructions don't have their own step number. So that when you click the button to hide or show rows, and you choose to hide some rows that are not relevant to your selected item, then the step numbers will always remain correct, whether or not those rows are showing that contain optional or additional instructions. Now, of course, if you were using a sheet that supported the advanced features for product families, you wouldn't have to worry about step numbering because it would take care of it for you. And when you click the button to generate report on a sheet that does not support the advanced features for product families, then the bottom radio button to generate a separate report worksheet for all codes in your entire DV sheet, that one is disabled. But the top three radio buttons are still available. And of course, if you had left the show columns hidden, then there wouldn't be any difference between as is and the for all rows, because no rows would be hidden. So it's pretty mistake proof for people who don't yet know what they're doing. But you do. You should now be familiar with the four optional ways to generate your WYSIWYG reports for very time-effective, mistake-proof, professional-looking work instructions.